हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम। इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन। सॉरी, इट इज नॉट द पल्स टाइम मॉड्यूलेशन, इट इज द पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन। सो इन पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन, इट इज बेसिकली प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय एनालॉग टू डिजिटल कन्वर्जन प्रोसेस। इट मीन्स हियर in the pulse code modulation we convert a analog signal into a digital signal, and in the case of another pulse modulation technique, the rate at which sample are taken and encoded must conform the Nyquist sampling rate. So the Nyquist sampling rate is a sampling rate must be greater than twice the highest frequency in the analog signal. That is called a Nyquist sampling rate. It means FS, it means the sampling frequency is greater than twice of the maximum frequency. It means higher maximum frequency in the analog signal. So in the PCM, the available range of the signal voltage is divided into the level, and each is assigned by the binary number. That is the basically process of conversion of a analog signal into digital signal. Each sample is represented by a binary number and transmitted serially. The number of the level available depends upon the number of the bits used to express the sample value, just like a 3-bit, 4-bit. So the number of the level is given by n, that is n equal to 2 to the power m. So these all about the pulse code modulation. So first, it's a pulse code modulation is used for the conversion of the analog signal into digital signal. And as per the Nyquist sampling rate, if the sampling rate is greater than the twice of the highest frequency component of the signal, then we are able to reconstruct the signal from its samples. It means we can easily convert a digital signal into an analog signal. In short, it's, we write FS is greater than twice FA, where FS is the signal frequency and FA is the maximum frequency component of the analog signal. Similarly, if in general way, PCM is, in the PCM, signal voltage is divided into the level and each level is assigned a binary number. So that is all about the pulse code modulation. So the first process is used for the signal conversion of analog signal into the digital signal is quantization, and quantization is a process of converting analog signal into PCM is called quantizing. Since the original signal can have divide infinite number of the signal level, the quantization process will produce the error called quantization error or quantization noise. So the dynamic range of the system is the ratio of the strongest possible signal that can be transmitted and the weakest discernible signal In a linear PCM system, the maximum dynamic range is founded by this particular equation. So actually, what is the quantization error? If you convert analog signal into the digital signal, first we take the samples. It means we divide the analog signal into the different samples. For example, if you divide analog signal into the sample, we got a voltage level that is 4.2. And in another case, we got a voltage level 4.8. So in the 5.2 and 4.8, both is represented as the 5. So you see, it means once we convert this digital signal to analog signal, an error of around 0.2 to 0.2 voltage will introduce. That is actually called a quantization error. See here, what is the quantization process? A continuous sample is passed to the quantizer, output is a discrete sample. And in this quantizer, GT has the different value, that is, they can represent MK, MK plus 1, MK minus. These are the basically MK is the decision level or decision threshold. Then amplitude quantization, it is basically process of transferring the sample amplitude m into a discrete amplitude, because the sample amplitude it may be 5.2, but the discrete it's got the high value high. Similarly, a sample amplitude having value 4.8, it's also got the high. Then only we are able to code this, because this particular 5 is represented in binary form. I'm already explained this, because first we take the samples, then we coded it into the binary number. So the 4.8, it is not possible to code it. So we convert this 4.8 to a nearest point. So it means the nearest number is 5. So you convert it into the 5. Similarly, 5.2 is also converted into the 5. So that is basically a sample amplitude and discrete amplitude. And then and this particular quantizer is used to quantize this signal. See here, if you see the quantization, it is divided into the two part, mid trend and mid rise. See the level is almost same, but it one so but one is called mid read level and here it's called the mid rise level. See here it, this and this only difference at this, here the reference is at the zero, so here the reference is center is of a particular one sample is the zero. See here why the quantization wise it will improve as I introduce. See, these are the basically samples. Once we have converted it into the analog signal, see here a noise. These are the basically called quantization noise. See here, it because this particular noise introduced the error in the signal. So that's why it is called a quantization noise. How it will introduce? I'm already explaining it to you. These are the basically method how to the quantization level is calculated. See here, the quantization noise is equal to delta square upon 2. Delta, we know the is basically the step size, and the step size is twice m max upon l. L is the total size. See this particular diagram. So basically L is the total size. See here, L equal to 2 to the power r, because it is we are finally convert into the binary number. And if it is the r is a number, then if you convert it into the bits per sample, so the r is log 2 into r L, and the delta is twice m max upon 2 to the power r. In that way again we can calculate the quantization noise. Once the quantization noise is calculated, then we can calculate the SNR, that is the signal to noise ratio, and this is the signal power divided by the noise power. After putting this value, we got this. It means an SNR increases exponentially with increasing r. See here, it is the 2 to the power r. Once we'll if you put P and M is constant, but we if we move this R, R is basically this number of the bits. It means if we increase the number of bits, SNR will improve. These are the some of the representation. If there is level is 32, number of the bit per sample is R, 2 to the power 5, 32. And then signal to noise ratio, they have just calculated for different value. For and tabulated it for your convenience. Then second process is called the compounding. This is also required to improve the dynamic range of the signal, because if in the case of the sampling, if a level of signal is small and if your sampling size is large, then this particular signal will not able to recognize by this sampling rate. It means there is a loss of the information. To remove this loss of the information, we use the compounding. Either we use the variable signal to variable sampling rate. Second, we use the technique called the compounding. So it is used to improve dynamic range. At compression is used on the transmitted end, and expanding is used on the receiving end. So this compression and expansion, if you combine it, called compounding. And similarly, after the compounding, we take the sample, then we compress it, then we convert it by then we use coding to convert this sample into a digital signal. So that is called the coding. Actually, inverse operation is called decoding, and if you combine both, it is called codec. So if we summarize all the step of a pulse modulator system and represent it in a block diagram, so the pulse modulator system first is the source, it first is the information, then we need to sample this information. So that in the sampling theorem, depends upon the sampling rate, and the sampling rate depends upon the maximum frequency component available in the signal, and the maximum frequency component is available in the signal. It means signal is the band limited. In any signal present in a environment is a not a band limited signal. So we pass it into the low pass filter so that a signal is converted into a band limited signal. This that is passed through a sampler. Output of the sampler is a discrete signal. Then we pass through the quantizer. After passing through the quantizer, it's have a unique levels. Then we pass through the encoder. Output of the encoder is a called PCM signal. It means first we convert a signal to the band limited signal. Then we take the sampling. Then we quantize. Then we code. Then after the coding, it's become a digital signal. Similarly, at the transmitter path, this particular is basically transmission path. So this signal will distort it. So once the PCM signal is received, first it's passed through a regenerator circuit so that the noise will remove. Then it's passed through the decoder, because here we use encoder. Then here we require decoder. Then if the both is combined and it's converted to the reconstruction filter, then it is converted into the analog signal. So these are the basically block diagram of the pulse code modulation. It means a pulse code modulation is a process of conversion of analog signal into digital signal. In this conversion of analog signal to digital signal, first analog signal is converted into a band limited signal. Then it is passed through a sampler where sampling is performed. Then it passed through a quantizer where quantization is performed, and output of the quantizer is a discrete signal. Then it's passed through an encoder. Then coding will perform, and after the coding, this analog signal is converted into a digital signal. Similarly, at the receiver end, we required a regeneration circuit, then we required a decoder, we required a reconstruction filter, and then our destination. So these are the basically our building block of pulse code modulation and demodulation. That's all about the today lecture. Thanks you for your attention.